Hey traders, I hope you guys are doing well. We got a little bit to talk about regarding Bitcoin, some magic internet money, if you will. So let's get right into it. We talked to it about 6 days ago, the 37,253 level being the key area to flip, just because it would establish this as a monthly support at that time. And then we can talk about ranging higher over time, back testing some of these other ranges along the way to 58K. Now, 58K is only a target due to point of control and high time frame range data. By no means does price have to get up this high, even if we flip 37,253. So we still have to be able to look at things objectively going forward. We can't just fall in love with these targets, okay? So what we would do is just kind of evaluate and go from there, because by no means is Bitcoin out of the woods just because it gets above this level. And it still hasn't done that yet. So let's get into it. We got 7 minutes. You guys know the rules. I'm going to show you guys some interesting stuff today. Down to the 2 hour here. So we're going to leave the June open up. If you guys recall, we were looking for this level. Now, if you follow me on TikTok, you got this video last night. I ran into some issues, technical issues, and so I didn't get my 7 minute video out last night, but we will get it today. This is your golden pocket. This was the box we're looking for, okay? We've come up right to the box. There was also some range data to support that this was a good area to look for. This is how the move developed on the weekly ranges. So if we are looking at things just from the weekly perspective, we've got our last 3 weeks up. I know that we're in a new week as of right now. We do need to start tracking this range soon. But you can see we closed outside of the value area high of last week, found acceptance into the prior week from the 6th to the 13th. What is the natural progression of range acceptance? You will cycle to the POC, which is also the value area low of this range. If we get inside of this range, we will challenge the June open. If we can flip that, I do expect us to at least make an attempt into this point of control here around that 40K resistance. If you guys recall, $40,000, that psychological and numerical resistance for Bitcoin. Now, we're going to talk a little bit about pivots here in a second, and this is going to be extremely dubious. So if you guys like that kind of thing where I show you guys like how my brain works and how I form my plans, I will get into that towards the end of the video, okay? So again, if we get rid of our weekly ranges, we're going to also look at the monthly range for those who have not seen it. That is your monthly value area high right here, right in your golden pocket. So this is an area that just makes a lot of sense. Now, we also need to keep in mind that there are also other important levels going forward. So we are going to take a look at some high time frame horizontals here. One of the key levels that I do want to point out to you is a bi-weekly level that lines up really nicely with some of our volume data. This 35,730 level is going to come into play at some point, in my opinion. So if we come over to our key levels, we turn on that bi-weekly level. You will notice it gets things pretty well and good. You get above this, we go to the June open, it seems too. So if you notice we get above this level, what do? We attack the June open. Back to the level, June open. Okay, lose the June open, bi-weekly level, right? Hold it for just a little bit and down, get above it, June open. Back to the June open here again, or back to the bi-weekly, back to the June open. So this is a really nice strong level. This is also a nice area to have in mind just because it's very relevant. So what we are doing with this bi-weekly level now is we are going to see if it holds any relevance going forward based on our range data as well. And so we're going to turn our weekly ranges back on. As you guys recall, I did mention getting above the value area low, then the June open, stair-stepping our way up potentially to this POC. So if we are able to do that, what you would find yourself with at this point is a bat into the POC, so a nice harmonic. You're getting that 0.5 retrace, a deeper one for a bat, because normally you're looking for that 382 to 0.5, 0.5 being ideal, then a 382 to 886 for C, and then you're looking for that 886 and 1618 to 2 point, I think it's 24 for the D leg. So this would actually be a really nice low time frame bat. This is all very dubious, guys. Remember, harmonics are one of those things where it's fun to get them right, but at the same time, we have to make sure that it lines up with our other analysis. So if we do get up to this level and sell off at the 40K region, 39,921 was a big area before, if you recall. Where do we target just structurally on harmonics when we get a completion zone and then it's a confirmed pattern? We target the B leg. So if we actually turn on our B leg right here, you'll notice that it comes in just beneath the bi-weekly level, and that is the key level we need to hold, both from a volume perspective here, if we're going to come back up and reclaim this POC on a high time frame. And that would be the key. This could even happen going into July, guys. This could be a July move. So losing this area would look bearish. And if we lose the area, where might we rotate back to? Well, we would come all the way back down to this prior weekly range. If we lose this weekly range, highs right here, this little consolidation or the B leg, so to speak, you really want to put your cutoff right around $34,000, $35,000. lose that level, guys, and we will probably cycle all the way back down to that key weekly level at $32,290. In this case, it's right around $32,700. And so that would be how that move would unfold. Do we have anything else saying that this could happen? Let's leave our biweekly level up and let's do a little bit of math. If you guys recall from the previous video, we were talking about how a pivot is calculated and what it is. It's just an average of price for a certain time frame, whatever it may be. Let's go out to the monthly here and get those averages and do some fun math. All right, guys, so let's take a look at our monthly pivot incoming and do some calculations just for fun, because we might as well make this a guessing game, right? So the high of the month is pretty safe to say at 41,338. We're pretty far away from that now. And the low of the month is 28,726.50. And then we have our current price at 36,209. Let's just make the assumption we close somewhere in that 37,253 range. Okay, we're going to divide this number by 3. And we get $35,772, our biweekly level we just spoke about, and the B leg of the bat. Let's pull it back up. Now let's look at that number, see if it makes sense. We've got this coming into a potential B leg right here, right? $35,786. The new monthly pivot would generate at $35,772 if we close around this June open. And if you recall, that is your TPO point of control for this entire consolidation right here, this nice blue line, very nice support and resistance. So that is how TA works. That's a pretty dubious TA because I'm trying to predict the future. But really, I'm just trying to see what my options may be if something like this were to play out, because it is on the table based on volume. It's on the table based on market structure, and it does support our average or pivot. Theories. So that is 7 minutes, guys. You know the rules. Leave me a like, subscribe, comment down below, because it lets me know to keep making this kind of content. And I will catch you guys in the next video. Trade safe.